It's the young people today that I care about. What are they doing? What are they thinking? Boy, that's important to me. And as I travel through the many malls of this great country of ours, inspecting my 725 franchises, I look out and I see your well-scrubbed, clean, shiny faces. And yes, there's a lump right here. I just swell up with pride. So right now, everyone, please, all my people, raise your right hand.
Come on, get them up.
And give yourself a pat on the back for a job well done. Come on.
That's it.
I think they'd rather have a raise.
Feel free to have a look around, sir.
Well, of course I feel free. I own the damn place. Joke.
Sir, I'd just like to say, in all sincerity, I've patterned my life after you, and it's an honor to meet you in the flesh.
Of course it is.
Hamilton, his fry is getting cold. Oh.
Perfect.
She's a sly one, that Alexis.
And I'm not going to apologize for that.
Global's got Dynasty, tonight at 9.
Don't you wish the whole world were as pure and natural as the wheat germ oil and honey in Fabergé Organic Shampoo? Lush fields of wheat give us pure wheat germ oil, and we blend it with smooth golden honey. These are nature's ingredients captured in a bottle. Fabergé Organic Shampoo, for natural shine and natural body. Fabergé Organic Shampoo and Conditioner. They can make a world of difference in your hair.
Welcome to my home and lifestyles of the rich and undeserving.
It's a laugh.
You are such a jerk.
It's a scream.
So I spazzed out.
It's a real panic.
Is something wrong?
April Fool's Day. Get ready to party till you drop.
Opens today at a famous Players Theater near you. Check local listings.
Smile, Canada. Wednesday, April 2nd is McHappy Day, the day everyone comes to McDonald's for a Big Mac. Because for every Big Mac sold, $1 goes to help Ronald McDonald Houses and local children's charities. McHappy Day, a special day. Local personalities help out behind the counter.
Oh, get us autographed.
Join the fun. Wednesday, April 2nd, have a Big Mac and help some terrific kids. Smile, Canada. McHappy Day, the day we all work together.
Will you be partying with us tonight, or are you just going to sulk?
If it's outrageous comedy you're looking for...
Well, you can know what the real deal is.
Stay up and laugh with Saturday Night Live.
Everyone loves it. It's going to be a huge success.
Global's got it. Saturdays at 11:30.
I forgot to announce something. This year, once again, I'm in charge of running the Festival of Human Potential. Oh, come on. What's this? The talent show. Oh. Come on. It's going to be fun. It's a great opportunity to, you know, to share your talents with the rest of the school. For instance, I'm going to be doing a song with Mr. Noodleman and Mr. Gambino.
Hot for teacher?
Oh, I thank you, Jeff. No. But, oh, wait. Now, come on. Seriously. Who can I count on? Who's going to sign up? Come on. It's going to be fun. Bill and Dean. Always Bill and Dean. All right, that's great. Anybody else? All right, you have until the end of the school day because there'll be tryouts this afternoon. Well, let me guess. Synchronized skateboarding? How did I know that?
Trust me, there's nothing to that. I tried it at home. I can't do it.
All right, let me just get this straight. You're lip-syncing, sweetest taboo. You're lip-syncing like a virgin, and you're lip-syncing like a virgin.
Stacey, there you are. Now, do you want to ride home or not?
Brad, Stacey and I were thinking of doing a duet.
You are? Oh, that's wonderful. Would you please just tell your friends that we need as much variety as we can get?
We were thinking of lip-syncing a song.
Really?
Stacey, are you sure about this? I mean, I've seen you try it at home, and you can't really do it.
Stacey, maybe all that Brad's trying to say is that, do you have any other talents?
I can paint scenery.
Wonderful.
What about me? I can't go up there alone.
Well,
Brad, why don't you do something with Linda? You're always doing Springsteen in the Mirror.
We'll do a duet.
Well, gee, I don't know. My lips are a little out of shape.
Well, if your evenings are too busy to rehearse with me.
On second thought, it might be kind of fun.
Linda Barrett and Brad Hamilton, the Sonny and Cher of Ridgemont.
Who?
Brad, you're to call the cattle burger as soon as possible.
Hey, they can't make a move without me.
Brad, what about the duet?
Yeah, sure, sign me up.
Cattleburger.
Hey, Dennis.
What's up?
Brad, brace yourself. It's Buck Whitman.
He came back. I'm on my way.
No, don't come down. He's not here. He's dead. He was in Albuquerque inspecting a cattle burger. Slipped on a grease spot and banged his head on the fryer. They say he never knew what hit him.
Grease spot?
The fast food world was shocked and saddened today by the freak grease spot accident that took the life of cattle burger founder Marion
Buck
Whitman. In 1968, Buck opened his first cattle burger in Haight-Ashbury, where he coined the phrase, "The only fresher burger is still saying moo." By the early 70s, Buck was catering fast food dinners at the White House and opening cattle burgers in Japan. He never realized his dream of opening Cattle Land featuring Buford the Bull and Peter the Potato. Buck Whitman, young, vibrant, dead.
Good job. So unfair.
Yeah. Can I change the channel now?
And as Theodore Roosevelt so artfully demonstrated, the key to diplomacy is speak softly and carry a big stick. Now, how does that relate to our foreign policy? That was not the bell. Sit down. Class is not over.
Excuse the interruption, Mr. Hand, but I need all those students who are involved in the Human Potential Festival.
You mean they're going to miss my class just to prepare for your circus of the would-be stars?
I'm afraid so. I've been allotted this period for rehearsal. Okay, so who's going? Who's involved? Let's go.
Come on.
Wow.
Well, Mrs. Spicoli, aren't you going to share your talents?
I'd love to, Mr. Hand. I could kick myself for not signing up.
Well, as long as you're here, we may as well use the time effectively. Now, Theodore Roosevelt was a man who always found him... Yes, Mr. Spicoli?
Can I go to the bathroom?
Yes, Mr. Spicoli, you may go to the bathroom.
Gnarly.
Sorry, Mr. Vargas.
Are you okay? You seemed a little out of it in class today.
Well, do you ever wonder how it is that one second a person can be alive, vibrant, and happening, and the next second they're gone?
Oh, the big questions. Life and death. Well, Brad.
What I've figured out is that we are essentially a random collection of molecules brought together by a force so incredible we can't even begin to comprehend its power. And yet, when you think about this, we're at the mercy of an endless number of factors that can snatch life from us.
Diseases, natural disasters, freak accidents, homicidal maniacs. A meteor could crash into the building. I may not even make it down the hall. Who knows?
Gee, life is so fragile.
Scary, isn't it? Have a nice day.
Watch him carefully. At no time do his hands leave his wrists.
There you have it. Mighty Mike and his flying fruit. Number one this week on Ridgemont Top 40.
Mike? Mark, that was wonderful. I had no idea you were so talented. The audience is going to love you.
I don't know, Miss Mellon. I mean, missing hands class is one thing, but I can't do this in front of people.
Oh, no, please. I wanted you to, you know, to MC the show.
All right, MC. Kind of like Johnny Carson?
Here's...
That's it. Oh, please. I know you will. You will. I know you will. Okay, come here. Let me talk to you about this. Come here.
Where is he? This is so unprofessional.
Ever since that Buck died, he's been even weirder than usual.
This won't do. Oh, Brad, where have you been? If you're going to do this, we've got to make a commitment to be on time.
Brad, you're doing I Love You, Babe.
No, I got you, Babe.
Oh, Babe, calm down. So what? We'll get that first.
Oh, okay.
Hit it.
What's wrong with you?
What's wrong? Look at us. What are we doing here? Who are we kidding? I mean, we're just avoiding the real issues. Doesn't anybody realize that in just an instant it can all be over? That every second we waste is another second that'll never come back. This second, right now, is over. It's gone. Well, wait, there goes another one. And then another, and another! Is this what it's all about? Is it all one big, horrible, cosmic joke?
Oh, nice, Hamilton.
Yeah. Oh, that was beautiful. Get to the salesman, right?
We could use that bit to break up the lip sync acts. He's the missing link.
Oh, that's perfect. You know, he could be the next Dustin Hoffman.
Anybody have any
change?
Pepsi, the choice of a new generation.
Those lovable graduates are back.
We're here.
Mahoney.
We're rubies.
What?
Hooks.
Don't move. Don't back.
Callahan. Hightower. Tackleberry.
Do you want to kill me?
Fackler. And Jones.
Shit.
Police Academy 3. Back in training. Because they need it.
Now playing at a theater near you. Check your local listings.
Hey, kids. Why have you made Brown Cow Canada's number one liquid milk mixer? Is it because of its rich chocolate taste? Or because it's great with milk? Or is it just downright delicious? Come on, kids of Canada, tell us how you really feel.
Moo. Moo.
Moo.
Cow, Canada's number one chocolate syrup.
Here we are in Lunenburg, Nova Scotia, for another Aniston poll. Once again, 100 families tried Aniston for 2 months instead of their regular pain medicine. How did Aniston do in Lunenburg? After the test, when we asked, are you still using Aniston, 83 of the 100 families said yes. What is it that wins people over? Aniston works, virtually every time, so people learn they can count on it. Aniston. In Lunenburg, 83% said yes.
Listen, you know that I understand the artistic temperament. I do. So if you don't want to do that, you know, your dramatic reading, then just go back to doing your duet.
Miss Mellon, do you ever think about dying?
Yes, Brad, of course I do. But don't you realize that you've got your whole life ahead of you? And me? Well, I take my spirulina and my selenium and mega doses of vitamin C. And then I have my amino acids and bee pollen. And I mix it all up with a little zinc, a little copper.
But aren't you ever afraid?
I covered that ground in fear therapy. I had the most wonderful mock funeral. And my ex-husband, he wrote a beautiful obituary that, I'll tell you, Brad, I'll never forget it.
But what about all of them? Why aren't they afraid?
Why don't you go ask them?
Barbara, do you ever get scared about the future?
How could I be scared about the future when I know that within the next 3 weeks, I could lose 12 to 15 pounds? I'm going to look so unreal.
So it's short-term goals that keep you going.
Well, yeah, that and the new pair of pants I'm going to be able to fit into.
You call that a philosophy of life?
You call that a shirt?
Damone, do you ever wonder how 1 minute a person can be alive, vibrant, and the next minute gone?
Hamilton, I can't worry about things like that now. I'm too busy looking out for this jerk.
Ratner, you've got half a brain. What do you think?
Well, I'm too busy watching out for this maniac.
You guys are pathetic.
I love that guy.
He's a million laughs.
There he is. I'm going to go straighten him out.
What are you smiling about? Don't you realize that you are just a fragile collection of molecules at the mercy of a million potential disasters? Now, doesn't that terrify you?
Brad, can I see you for a sec? I'm worried about you.
Hmm?
But I've got the solution.
Hmm?
Yeah, you've just got to snap out of it.
Why didn't I think of that?
I don't know.
You know, you should be one of those radio shrinks.
I was just trying to help. Would you feel better if we canceled our song?
No. You want me to do the song? I'll do the song.
Okay. See, once you're up there performing and having fun, you'll feel so much better.
I wish it were that simple, Linda. I wish I could be as blissfully ignorant as everybody else. But I can't. What's an intelligent person to do?
Hamilton, what you're going through is perfectly normal. It's human nature to wrestle with these questions every 8 to 10 years. It'll pass in a couple of months.
That's just it, Mr. Hand. We might not even be here in a couple of months.
Look, if it's any reassurance, there isn't a man alive who won't struggle with these exact questions.
Who put these here?
Except maybe one.
It's like everybody's running around out there doing all this stuff. But the stuff is just, like, there to distract us from what's really happening.
Yeah.
Yeah!
Oh.
I'm going to be late for the talent show.
No, you guys go ahead.
Dude, you're one of us now.
Let's hear it again.
time for those material girls.
Hey, look at that.
And believe me, I'm sure they're all virgins. Okay, we have some celebrities in the audience tonight, and who better to introduce them than Mr. Pee-wee Herman.
Hi, boys and girls.
Hi, Pee-wee.
Okay, let's get things started. Okay. So, in our audience, we have the whole Ridgemont chess team. I think they deserve a big hand.
Isn't it wonderful, ladies and gentlemen? All right, thank you. Okay, and now to introduce our next act, a very, very special guest star. Let's give him a warm Ridgemont welcome. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Woody Allen.
Thank you. I'm thin but fun. It is now, I guess the word is, privilege to introduce my personally favorite social science teachers, Peter, Paul, and Mellon.
Are we all having fun? Did I tell you?
Walking through the desert on a horse with no name. Well, it's good to be out of the rain.
He wasn't at home. He wasn't at work. Could something have happened to him?
Linda, don't worry about him. Brad likes to act like the whole world is coming to an end and then make a big dramatic appearance.
Okay. I'm going out for some air.
I loved your impressions.
I love your abstract graphic.
It's a rainbow.
Oh, I like it that way.
Okay, then you guys are synchronized, so do everything together. Come on, you're gonna miss the party.
Well, you go ahead. I think I'm gonna party in here by myself.
Okay.
Hi. Why are you here?
Linda, if I knew the answer to that question, I wouldn't be here.
Brad, I've been thinking about what you're going through, and you've got to concentrate on all the good things in your life. Friends, family, job.
Selling dead meat?
What about your car? It's the best car in school.
Linda, do you know how old that car is? How much longer do you think I have before the engine blows?
It just kills me to see an intelligent, hardworking, sexy, healthy guy.
Wait a minute. What was that last thing you just said about me?
Healthy?
No. The sexy part.
Well, I always thought you were sexy.
Well, what's so sexy about me?
Well, you know.
No, I don't. Tell me.
Your eyes are very sexy.
No kidding. You know, for a second there, I almost forgot about everything that was bothering me.
I'll bet I could help you completely forget.
Really?